السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا وحبيبنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. I say السلام عليكم. I like to hear وعليكم السلام louder than me at least. السلام عليكم. صلوا على النبي. Say اللهم صلي على محمد وعلى آل وأصحاب محمد. We have been listening to the lecture from Brother Mawlana Siddiqui. There are two kinds of lectures. One kind is asking you to do something, like distributing duties. And other kinds of lectures actually motivating, forcing the person to work. Or let's say recharge your battery. Or let's say the power will be connected, inshallah. Such meeting, such holiday, and I really envy you that you have Mawlid al-Nabi is national holiday. In Damascus is not national holiday. What we have national holiday in Damascus is Yawmul Hijrah, the migration of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. But it's not national holiday, Mawlid al-Nabi there, but it is actually the day when you see the decoration and light and lot of lights and light of and a lot of happiness and enjoyment all the way, all the street, all around. And almost every child will carry a bag of candies and they compete with each other how much I collect, how much you collect. And nowadays they compete with each other how much money you collect, how much. The other will compete, believe me, how much books or how much or how many literatures or brochures or so you collect. The life of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the best example for all of us all. And his example for all of us. He gave example how to live with all denominations, with all kind of people. In the first 13 years, he was facing one kind of people, atheist. Then the second 5 years, he was facing the Jews. Then the last 5 years, he was facing the hypocrites and the Russia and America, sorry, not Russia and America, Rome and Persia, which they are, look like, represent the same. But I like to focus today about the plan of Roman Empire to abort or to stop the da'wah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. They were doing a lot and plot and many plans to abort and to stop this da'wah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And we are in Yawm al-Nabi to learn how Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam dealt with these people and dealt with others to learn well. So we said first 13 years in Mecca with atheists, he was using patience with them. To extreme patient. And these to teach us a lot of wisdom, lot of open mind. That can you imagine Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam making salah and tawaf around the Kaaba while 360 idols and statue were there. We look like the same right now. If you have a travel in the country or most of the countries of the West, you will see a lot of statues, lot of idols. Rasulullah lived like this for 13 years, but he was not planning, he was managing how and which way we have to spread the truth to these people by a lot of patience, lot of dialogue, lot of talk One day he was sitting in the Haram, in the Kaaba. Then the people of Mecca, they were all atheists. Actually, they were keen about their business, about their leadership, about their position. They knew Rasulullah is a messenger and true, but they're afraid of their leadership. They said, if we follow you, all people will kill us in one night. So they send him a message, come, we need to talk. He was sitting, making zikr. He immediately stood and ran toward them like magnet while he was collecting his clothes to sit with them and to speak with them and to open dialogue with them. We were with the brother Naeem coming from Georgetown to here. We passed by 2-3 Masjid al-Ahmadiyya. I asked, is there any dialogue between Muslim, Sunni and Ahmadiyya? The answer is yes or no?
No.
طيب. The time we are spending and fighting with each other about Mawlid al-Nabi, haram or halal, or do it or not do it, let's spend this time to make the people at least understand each other. That is required. That is needed, especially in this time. The enemies of Islam, when they are attacking Islam, they don't tell the difference between Shi'i and Muslim and Sunni and Ahmadi and all. They all consider them Ahmadis. Sorry, they all consider them following Ahmad, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, or Muhammad. The enemies of Islam, they did not tell the difference among Muslims. They did not address us as a Shi'i or Ahmadi or Sunni or Salafi or Sufi or Mawlid or Mawlid Miladun Nabi or Mawlid Yawmun Nabi or Hubbun. They don't tell that. They are all gathered together to put down the Muslims. And some Muslims, unfortunately, they are doing the job of the enemy of Muslims more, to divide the Muslim, to create a lot of controversial.